if you told me that she was going to be my wife 12 years ago, I would have ran to the closest place and married her then. My favorite thing about Kerri is that she is just a strong, beautiful woman, and she's perfect in every way.
When I wake up, well, I know I'm gonna be the man who wakes up next to you.
I always knew that I wanted to marry Kerri.
Yeah, I know I'm gonna be the man who goes along with you. And when I come home, yeah, I know I'm gonna be the man who's coming home to you. And when I'm dreaming, well, I know I'm gonna dream about the time when I'm with you. But I would walk 500.
I knew I loved Kerri the first time we hung out.
500 more, just to be the man who walked.
That looks really, really good.
Oh.
Get the word out.
Oh, this well, do you wanna? Was at Starbucks. He said, "Remember that thing that someone said?" Because someone asked us if we were boyfriend and girlfriend in high school, and he goes, "Remember that thing?" And I said, "Yeah." And he goes, "Well, do you wanna?" And I was like, "Really? That's what you're gonna say? Well, do you wanna?" And then this wanna get water ice was at Washington Lake Park the second time around. This is where we met for our first date of that time, and we didn't want to leave each other, so we were thinking of like different things to do, and we went to Rita's water ice. And then this "Will You Marry Me" is obviously the Poconos, and "I Do" is here.
Aww.
So then there's
dry out.
A wooden necklace, and it has the date, and then it says, "What's an adventure to do?" And on the other side it says, "But rest these feet at home with you." Because that's the end of like our song. It's called "Walk Through Hell" is the song from high school.
Yeah, I know I'm gonna be the man who's working hard for you. And when the money comes in for the work I do, I'll pass along every cent of it to you. And when I'm lonely, well, I know I'm gonna be the man who's lonely without you. And if I grow old, well, I know I'm gonna be the man who's growing old with you. But I would walk 500 miles, and I would walk 500.
How did you guys start dating?
So in 2006, I spotted Eric in study hall, and I wrote to my friend at the time that I needed to meet the person with the big hair in study hall because he had gigantic curly hair. And I would time it so that I could get out the door at the same time as him because I was across the room. I would try to like rub shoulders basically. Like I would try to get in his vicinity, and like it worked out sometimes and sometimes it didn't. And then we ended up having mutual friends. So they staged it because they knew that I wanted to meet him. They staged it at one of our friend's house, and he didn't talk at all. He didn't say a word. So I thought that he was like, I don't even know, like extremely ridiculously quiet. So at one point we're sitting on the couch next to each other, and I felt something like on my leg, and I looked at him and I said, "Did you just touch my leg?" And he just like held up a bottle cap, and I was like, okay, that was weird. So then on the drive home, he was the driver, and he kind of started to talk to me, like give me little smiles, and we were listening to music. It was Newfound Glory. So that album is like super, you know, special, nostalgic.
Just to be the man who walked 1,000 miles to fall down at your door. But I would walk 500 miles, and I would walk 500 more. Just wish to be
What if I told you 12 years ago that he was gonna be your husband?
Oh my God. So 12 years ago, I probably would have said, yeah, sure, ha ha ha. And then if you would have told me when we were broken up, I would have said you were absolutely insane because I never thought that that would be the path that I was going down. But I am so thankful that I realized that I was missing something huge in my life.
Fall down at your door. When I wake up, well, I hope I'm gonna be the man who's waking up to you. And when I'm dreaming, well, I know I'm gonna dream about the time I had with you.
It's the beginning of a remarkable journey for this couple.
Kerri, would you like to begin first?
Sure.
Eric, today you will become my husband.
Eric, today you will become my husband.
I promise to love you with all my heart.
I promise to love you with all my heart.
From now until eternity.
From now until eternity.
I cannot wait to begin building our life together. Your turn, Eric. Kerri, today you will become my wife.
Kerri, today you will become my wife.
I promise to love you with all my heart.
I promise to love you with all my heart.
From now until eternity.
From now until eternity.
I cannot wait to begin building our life together.
I cannot wait to begin building our life together.
Let us proceed. Eric and Kerri, it's time to join hands. Eric, before your family and friends, do you take Kerri as your beloved wife to have and to hold through laughter and in sadness, through challenges and successes, so long as you both shall live? Kerri, before your family and friends, do you take Eric as your beloved husband to have and to hold through laughter and sadness, through challenges and successes, so long as you both shall live? Under the eyes of God, I happily pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride.
My favorite part about Eric is the way that he gets me. It's like he can understand certain things about me that like other people kind of can't. It's almost like we share something like very special that like is unspoken, and that's just the reason why I feel like we needed to be together so badly. It's just because he just knows like exactly how I'm feeling, exactly, you know. I know that he understands me, and that's like a hard thing, you know what I mean?
When did you know you loved him?
I would probably say like the second date. I do remember it was very awkward because when you're a kid, you know, you don't know like how to do the whole dating thing. So we sat at Applebee's and we were so nervous that we looked at each other and we both said, "Do we just want to order appetizers?" And he was like, "Mm-hmm." So we ordered appetizers, and shortly after that, so it might have been about the third date or something, shortly after that, it was a very, like, kind of fast-paced, like, whirlwind type of thing. So by the time we started dating in November, I had only known him for, like, 2-3 weeks, and I knew I loved him then. My favorite memory is when we got back together. So we were apart for 4 years, and he requested me on Facebook right at the time that I was planning on messaging him, so it was like a really weird cosmic thing. So finally, he had asked me if I wanted to meet up, so we went to Washington Lake Park, and that's my favorite memory because when I got out of my car, I knew I was done.
For everybody that doesn't know me, some of this is going to be off the cuff. First of all, before I talk about how much I love you, I want everybody to understand this guy right here. I love him so much. And the only time in their entire relationship where he ever made me cry was tears of joy. And it was because I said, I love you, and he didn't say his usual response, which is,
thanks.
He actually said it back, and I don't know why, I don't remember why he said it. I called him on a good day, and I burst into tears. This is what I got to deal with. Most favorite people, as they start their married life together, I feel so lucky to be able to share this day with the two of you, and even more lucky to call you my sister. From the moment we met, when our parents placed you into my arms, I knew that I was meeting my very best friend and one of my greatest treasures in life. I remember crying tears of joy with you inside my arms because I knew that I would never be lonely ever again. Our relationship is so special, and I'm convinced it's because we shared our room and I never slept in bed alone, even though you had your own bed. She's afraid of the dark. Thank you for being my biggest support, the best aunt and friend that I could ever need. Thank you for finding your way to each other and for bringing Eric into our lives. Now we officially have another brother, and my boy has another uncle to be his best buddy for life. I'm so excited to see what the future has in store for the two of you together.
And so I just wanted to say that I'm so proud of you. You know, we've been through a lot. I remember, this was the second go-around for Kerri and Eric, and I remember when she came home and she said to me, what do you think? Do you think I can go back? And I said, well, if anybody could do something like that, I think it's the two of you. And it just goes to show, you know, first love is always the best. I just wanted to say that, you know, just one thing, always tell the person that you're with that you love them. You know, you can never get enough of that. Never go to bed angry. Always be with your partner. Hug them, kiss them, you know.